हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन दीज प्रॉपर्टी सीरीज आर नेक्स्ट वीडियो इज ऑल अबाउट कम्यूटेटिव प्रॉपर्टी। व्हाट इज द एग्जैक्ट मीनिंग ऑफ दिस कम्यूटेटिव? दिस इज अ वर्ड डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द वर्ड कम्यूट, एंड दिस कम्यूट वर्ड इज अ फ्रेंच वर्ड विच हैज अ मीनिंग टू स्विच। एग्जैक्टली व्हाट वी डू इन दिस प्रॉपर्टी, let's see example. Here I have added two numbers, that is 4 plus 5. Next I have changed the positions of the digits, 5 plus 4, but you are watching that the number that I have added gives the result which is the same. Whether we add 4 plus 5 or we add 5 plus 4, we'll get the same number, same result, which is a 9. And yes, this is commutative property is. Let us take next example. Here I have taken 5 plus 0. Now switching the positions of the digits 0 plus 5, but we got the same answer. Again, if I multiplied the two numbers 6 multiplied by 3, we'll get 18. And if I switch the numbers 3 multiplied by 6, then again I get 18. It means these whole numbers are commutative under addition as well as multiplication. Let's move for the integers. Whether this commutative property under addition as well as multiplication occur or not, let us take example. If I add minus 5, which is an integer, and minus 6, which is also an integer, if we add it, we get minus 11. And if I switch the positions of the digits, minus 6 first and then minus 5, and we have added it, we'll get 11 again. It means integers are commutative under addition. If I go for this multiplication, here I have taken minus 7 multiplied by minus 4. Switching the positions, minus 4 multiplied by minus 7. But I am getting the same answer, 28. It means what is the conclusion? Integers are commutative under addition as well as multiplication. If I go for the rational numbers, will it happen the same? Let us check. Minus 2 by 4 plus 3 by 4. These two are rational numbers. We know it. And if I switch the positions of the digits, 3 by 4 first and then minus 2 by 4, if I add them, I'll get minus 4 both of the times. It means rational numbers are commutative under addition, because we are getting the same answer while switching the positions of the digits. Let's move for the multiplication. If I take two rational numbers and multiply them, and if I switch them and then multiply, but the answer is the same I am getting. It means the rational numbers are commutative under addition as well as multiplication. It means what we understood during this whole. The whole numbers are commutative under addition and multiplication because we are switching the positions of the numbers in additions as well as in multiplication. But the answer is remaining same. It means whole numbers are commutative under addition as well as multiplication. If we take integers and in addition as well as in multiplication, we have switched off all the positions of the numbers, but the answer is remaining same. It means what is the conclusion? Integers are also commutative under addition as well as multiplication. And when we go for the rational numbers having the same, that two numbers we have taken here, added them, and answer is same. Here, two numbers are multiplied and the answer is same. It means rational numbers are commutative under addition and multiplication. Now think about what are the two sets of numbers which are not commutative. Did you get your answer? Yes. In addition as well as in multiplication, the commutative property hold. But when we go for subtraction and division, will we get the same answer if we switched the numbers? Think over it. We'll discuss it later. So, what is the commutative property tells us? Commutative property explains that order of terms doesn't matter while performing any operation. But in which case? Only in addition and in multiplication. Now try commutative property under subtraction and division. We'll discuss later. Thank you so much for this video.